So here we go. All right, so the first thing we have to do is we have to take our watermelon and peel it down. So I treat a watermelon kind of just like we treat an orange. All right, well, what we do is we give ourselves a nice platform, cut a little bit on the top, cut a little bit on the top, on the bottom, flip it over so that we have, and we start to do that, right? It's real simple, very easy, uncomplicated. Okay, so we're gonna cut them into sort of medallions, right?
Yep.
Seedless watermelon.
Right.
So here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna actually just paint this watermelon with a little bit of olive oil.
Interesting.
Okay, a little bit of olive oil on there. A little bit of salt.
A lot of water on this watermelon, obviously.
So now you got the sweet and the savory.
So the olive oil will hold on it though, okay, right?
It will.
Okay.
We're gonna get our pan real hot here.
All right.
Okay. And then we're gonna just give this a good grill.
Oh, I love that sound.
I put a little bit of cheese on here. Right. Same process here. A little bit of olive oil, a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper. So here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make a pickling liquid. I used a little bit of red wine, a little bit of red wine vinegar. A little bit of sugar.
Alright.
Okay, and then I'm gonna put all these different type of aromatics. I have mustard seed, some cardamom. You can use anything you want. That's the beauty of pickling liquid, is that it really depends on what your feelings are about flavor profile. The red onion, real simple. We're gonna cut it off. We're gonna take that first layer off. We're gonna put this probably in a jar, masonry jar, ready, right?
Yep.
Sterilized, ready to go. And then you're gonna bring this up to a boil. Once that comes to a boil, you're gonna pass it like that.
Okay.
Through this, let it cool down, put it in your refrigerator at least one day.
At least one day.
So you wanna strain, the spices when you pour it over.
Exactly, just like that.
Gotcha.
Ah, okay.
I thought you would cook the onions, but you don't. You're just putting the brine over them.
So you just wanna get them, you don't wanna get them soft. You want still to have some texture.
Right.
You want all the flavor that this is giving you in that onion, but you want that onion to have a little bit of texture as well. All right, so we're gonna take a little bit of this olive oil now.
Okay. And there's stuff in there. What's in that olive oil?
I just seasoned it with a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and a little oregano, a little Greek oregano.
All right.
This is just a little bit of balsamic vinegar. Just a little bit of this mint. And if you want to have just a little bit of crystallized ginger. Now, I always serve it, believe it or not, with just a little bit, a nice piece of grilled baguette bread, just to soak up any of the juices that are falling, and you're ready to go. I think it's a real simple, fresh, but very flavorful, full flavor.
Yes, yes.
Flavor impact high.
And what we're showing here, you guys, is these two great chefs standing right here are really the men behind the food. And of course, these recipes transcend into a chip.
Yes.
I mean, that's what it's all about.
The experience of flavor using all natural ingredients.
Remember to go to the website. Everything is there. The recipe is there. All the flavors are there. And remember,
no artificial flavors, no MSG, no preservative.
You did a beautiful job.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was really nice.
It looks good.
That was great.